GOP-Trump trade fight boils over with threat to cars. President Trump and congressional Republicans are barreling toward a showdown over auto tariffs, just the latest conflict between the president and his party on trade. Trump has asked Commerce Secretary percent can be levied against auto imports for national security reasons. The mere suggestion of the huge tariffs sparked an immediate backlash on Capitol Hill, as well as GOP-friendly business groups and key trading partners already unnerved by Trump on trade. GOP lawmakers warn the tariffs could roil the economy months before a midterm election where they are fighting to maintain control of Congress. "I hope we can avoid getting into any kind of tariff situation," Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, RKY, told Fox News. "I think all of us are hoping that all of this back and forth discussion about trade doesn't end up leading into the implementation of tariffs or some larger trade war." Some senators used a closed-door lunch this week with Vice President Pence to complain about the saber rattling. A handful spoke, but I would say there was more than a handful interested in the topic and sharing with the Vice President, since he was there, some of those concerns, said Senator John Cornyn, R. Texas. The administration would be conducting a Section 232 investigation to impose tariffs on autos. The Section 232 law, which is rarely used, allows tariffs to be placed on imports in the name of national security, but many think such concerns do not apply to imported cars. "There are a number of members who are concerned about using national security as a cover for essentially economic protectionism," Cornyn said. Senator Bob Corker, R10, raised the issue with Secretary of State Mike Pompeo during an unrelated hearing, saying the administration is running its trade policy too transactionally. He called the floated auto tariffs absolutely an abuse of the president's authority. "To me, it feels like it has more to do with domestic politics, or some other issue, and I hope that will be abandoned quickly. I think it's dangerous and destabilizing," said Corker, whose state is home to a Volkswagen plant. Tariffs could shake up the state Senate race, which Republicans view as key to determining which party controls the chamber next year. Corker is retiring, and Representative Marsha Blackburn, R10, and former Governor Phil Bredesen, D, are locked in a closely watched battle heading into November. The prospect of auto tariffs comes as Republicans are already on edge over a reported deal between Trump and Beijing to save Chinese telecommunications giant ZTE and less than productive talks aimed at renegotiating the North American Free Trade Agreement, NAFTA. They also come on the heels of Trump's decision to impose steep tariffs on steel and aluminum imports for national security reasons using the same Section 232 law. "I didn't think aluminum and steel met the test," said Senator Roy Blunt, RMO, a member of the GOP Senate leadership. "I certainly don't think automobiles meet the test. I just don't think it's a national security issue." Senator Jeff Flake, R. Arizona, a vocal GOP critic of the president who is retiring after 2018, said the administration is using national security to enact protectionist policies. "When the steel and aluminum tariffs proceeded, many of us warned that other international partners would react similarly and use national security concerns to mask protectionism. Little did we know that it would be the U.S. who went back to the same ill-advised well so quickly," Flake said in a statement. The Trump administration is defending the move, arguing national security and economic concerns overlap when it comes to trade. "National security is broadly defined to include the economy, to include the impact on employment, to include a very big variety of things," Ross said on CNBC's Squawk Box. "Economic security is military security. And without economic security, you can't have military security," he added. The Trump administration is using tariffs as a primary weapon to combat what it calls unfair trade treatment on U.S. products around the globe. But the move risks alienating key business groups long considered influential allies for a Republican administration. Thomas Donahue, the president of the Chamber of Commerce, said in a statement that the auto tariffs aren't about national security but the administration trying to use trade penalties as leverage in separate, larger negotiations, such as NAFTA. The proposal, if carried out, would deal a staggering blow to the very industry it purports to protect and would threaten to ignite a global trade war, he said. Section 232 authorities should not be abused in this way. Business Roundtable, a group of the nation's top CEOs, said tariffs on auto imports doubles down on a bad precedent for U.S. trade policy. It undermines our nation's credibility in the global community, weakens the international trading system and emboldens other countries to use national security to limit U.S. goods and services exports to their markets, BRT said. We will follow this new investigation very closely. We will, as ever, be firm in standing up for the interests of UK industry as we continue to do, together with EU partners, on the US steel and aluminium tariffs.